Does that not a reference to what certainly looks to the layman like obstruction of justice?
It does look like that to the layman. I mean, Senator Santorum, what do you say? When you read it, I just fired the head of the FBI. He was crazy, a real nut job. I faced great pressure because of Russia. That's taken off. How do you sugarcoat that, Senator?
Well, first, I don't think Donald Trump believed that the firing of Jim Comey is going to take away the Russian investigation. I don't think he did. I don't think he believed it when he fired him. I don't think he believed it when he said that. I don't think he believes it now.
So then why did he say, I faced great pressure, that's taken off?
Because Donald Trump, the idea that people are outraged that Donald Trump says outrageous things. Where have you been in the past 18 months? I mean, come on. I mean, let's this feigning of outrage. I understand, you know, it's all unique circumstances, but this is who the American public elected. They elected someone who is outrageous at many times, and now most of the time, it seems like, in some of the things he says. And it does put people, you know, off. It creates all sorts of incendiary remarks from those who don't like him. But the bottom line is, Donald Trump, I don't believe, was fired Jim Comey because he thought he was ending the FBI investigation. He's not a fool. It didn't end the FBI investigation. As you've seen, it's actually created more of an investigation. And the idea that joking around with the Russians...
Senator, it has in the past few days because of all of these revelations, but clearly when he had this meeting, he thought the pressure would go away.
I mean, unless he's just point blank lying to their face. I don't believe Donald Trump believed that firing Jim Comey was going to end this investigation. He knew the investigation was going to continue.
Senator, first of all, what you're saying is that we should not believe a word the president says in public or private because he's a liar.
What a great
Second of all, Senator, Donald Trump uses hyperbole regularly, and you can't take a lot of what he says literally. You're saying that the American public understands that Donald Trump uses hyperbole slash lies all the time, and therefore he shouldn't be held to his word. But if that were true and a constant standard, you would have sung an entirely different tune during the Clinton impeachment hearings. You would have said the American people understand this is part of Bill Clinton's character, and therefore it's not surprising and not serious, but you didn't. So you got to apply the same standards to both sides, and you know you're spinning.
No, I'm not spinning because, look, I ran against this guy. I understand the hyperbole. I understand what he does. Do I believe that it's proper conduct from a president? No, I don't. I wish he didn't do it.
Okay, so let's own that.
And I do own that, and I've said it repeatedly, and I'll continue to say it. But don't you know, overreact to a president who's been doing this for 18 months in every conceivable setting you can imagine.
Under the bus to the Russian foreign minister? What is worth overreacting to then, Senator?
I would say what's worth overreacting to is to show that the president of the United States actually, number one, has tried to obstruct justice, and I don't think there's any evidence of that at this point. And number two, and this is very important, that the whole basis of this investigation, that there was collusion between the Trump campaign and the Russians, there is still no evidence to point to that. And so,
except the president's own words.
To joke about that, in my opinion, would actually be appropriate to do, given what's been made of this.
In the New York Times article, as reported by Matthew, he talked to several government officials. Juliet, one of them, who was actually it's defending the president, didn't deny that he said this. Just, I want to make it clear. They're not denying that he said this, okay?
Sure,
this person, though, defended the president, saying it was, quote, a negotiating tactic of the president's designed to get concessions out of the Russians, that that's why he said these things. Does that make any sense to you?
It makes sense in the sense that that's what we hear from the White House. This is Trump admitted, right, to disclosing classified information about likely an Israeli asset in an ISIS cell who was delivering us information and said that was a humanitarian declassification. So I don't buy any of that. And I just, one of the challenges with all these unbelievable headlines, you know, from the New York Times and other newspapers, is that we tend to forget the cumulative evidence. So we're talking about this one piece today and just looking at it from someone who's a lawyer and someone who's been in counterterrorism and national security. So if I'm looking at this, I've got the firing of Comey, right? I've got a interview with Lester Holt in which the president says that, you know, he sort of wants it to end. I've got tweets that say he views the entire Russia investigation as a joke. And then then we have Comey's memo saying that he wink and a nod. And then we have the news today. And I just want to, so we have to look at this cumulatively, and cumulatively, It's bad. There's just no question about it. Yeah. And you can say it's a joke, and then, but it's not. It's actually the rule of law. It's about the investigation.
Which,
one final thing on the senator's point. This is not about collusion only. People like me have not been talking about collusion. It is very likely this investigation has to do with financial dealings, which we've been talking about as well over the last couple months. So if you put collusion on a pedestal, we may not get there, but still a lot of bad stuff has been done.
So I just also want to make sure I understand, Alan, on this issue of obstruction of justice, right, and you now have the White House lawyers looking at impeachment, just so that viewers truly understand here, obviously there is a criminal and legal standard for obstruction of justice that it seems many believe this wouldn't quite make, even though I think to a lot of people watching, they would think it would. Okay, fine. But just to be clear, when it comes to impeaching a president of the United States, the criminal standard for obstruction of justice is not what needs to be met.
Nobody knows the answer to that question. Look, I'm a civil libertarian, and I'm shocked that so many liberals and civil libertarians want to broaden the already far too broad obstruction of justice statutes, one of the worst statutes on the books from a civil libertarian point of view. They want to convict somebody based on puffing and hyperbole. If the shoe were on the other foot, and, you know, I am consistent, I was strongly opposed to the impeachment of President Clinton, somebody has to speak up for civil liberties. The ACLU is not doing it. The Democrats aren't doing it. The Republicans are happy with the special counsel. The media is thriving on blockbuster reports every day. Somebody has to stand up for civil liberties.
But, you know, if you look to it, if you
we have to distinguish between what's bad.
What you all are saying is intent doesn't matter. I mean, what he's saying here, I think to most people would seem he had the intent to obstruct justice, right? He had an FBI director. He fired him because he had great pressure because of Russia, and that's taken off. Now we know that the investigation is going to continue, and if anything, has actually gotten much more intense because we have a special prosecutor.
Sure.
So his intent may have been to obstruct, but because he didn't succeed, therefore it's not obstruction?
This is a completed obstruction, arguably. And I disagree with Alan's assessment. You know, Alan's reaching back to Aaron Burr's trial and Thomas Jefferson's.
Those people wrote the Constitution.
Yes, I know they did. And but Richard Nixon was, the impeachment charges against him, one of the biggest ones was based on obstruction of justice. And, of course, Bill Clinton, obstruction of justice.
Because modern
history suggests that obstruction is a perfectly acceptable charge if you can prove it. And I say that after today, when he talks about Comey being a nut to the Russians and says the pressure is off in the Russian investigation, it certainly looks like he fired Comey to suppress the Russia investigation.
And now they're not. That's obstruction. Sorry, Senator, is that.